Hi, I'm Dimitri, and in this video I'll cover all of the ways to categorize time tracking data in Clockify, how categorizing works, and how you can manage and organize your data. Let's dive in. Each time entry in Clockify contains information that helps you categorize time and later analyze it more easily. The main categories in which time entries are organized are descriptions, tasks, projects, and clients. They work as a hierarchy, starting from clients on the top, through projects, then tasks, and then descriptions. This means that each client can have multiple projects, and that each project can have multiple tasks. And further categorization with tags and descriptions can be done per entry, per task. In the workspace settings, you can see and change labels for clients, projects, and tasks to something else. Click on the label and then change it to another category. Or you can click on custom and type and create labels that make sense to you and your company. For this video, we'll use clients, projects, and tasks to demonstrate how time categorization works. There are multiple fields in each entry that describe what we're working on and where we can find it. The description field is used to describe what you're working on, and you can type whatever you want. The project, on the other hand, is defined in advance, and you use it to categorize the time into buckets. Click on the project button and select the project you want from the list. To select a specific task you're working on, you can expand the list here. And now when you click on a task, the project is automatically linked. A client is automatically selected every time you select a project. If you've got a lot of projects and tasks, you can favorite your most used ones, or you could just search them. You can search by clients and project, but you can also enable task filter in the profile settings and search by task name using the task at project syntax. For even further categorization, you can use tags. Tags work across projects, and they help you group entries by some topic in reports. For example, you can use tags to denote that an entry was invoiced, done as overtime work, and so on. To add a tag, click on the tag icon and choose a tag from the list. What's great about tags is that an entry can have multiple tags and you can filter reports by them. And finally, each entry can be billable or non-billable. When an entry has this blue icon, it means it's billable, and it'll be used when calculating the billable amount. However, if it's gray, its billable rate is zero. To mark an entry as billable or non-billable, click on the currency symbol. You can change the default USD currency to another one in the workspace settings. Open the currency list and click on the one you need. You'll notice that the tracker page also shows that currency now. If you want to add a new one, click Edit, then add the currency, and then type the one you need. To have a list of clients, projects, tasks, and tags predefined, you first need to create them. Let's start with clients. Choose the clients page in the sidebar. At the top right, you will see a field where you can add a new client. Type in the client name and click Add. The new client will now appear in the list. Afterwards, you can click on the pen icon at the right to add more details to the client. Enter the client's email, address, any important notes when working with them, and you can also change the currency in which you will bill them. Click Save and the client information is complete. In case you no longer work with any of the clients from your list, click on the three dots next to them and click Archive. If that client didn't have any projects associated with them, you'll be able to archive them just by confirming the action in the pop-up window. But if they do have projects associated with them, you'll have to confirm that you also want to archive the projects associated with them. In that case, check the box next to that option and confirm the archiving action in the pop-up window. Now let's create a project. Select the projects page from the sidebar. Click Create New Project in the top right corner. Now you'll see this pop-up window with project details that you need to add. Add a project name, choose a client associated with it, choose a color for the project, mark it as public to be visible to everyone, or uncheck the box to make a project private. This way only a few people can see and track time on it. Click Create and you'll see a project in the list. To create tasks for the project, click on the project from the list. Type in the task name in the top right field and click Add. If you want to assign specific people to that task, click on this dropdown and check the team groups or specific people that you want to assign. If a task has a particular user or group as the assignee, only that person or people can select and track time on that task. Turn the switcher off or on to mark the task as billable or non-billable, and if needed, you can set rates for the task. When you create a project and its tasks, you can save it as a template. Click on the three dots next to the project and click Set as a template. You'll notice a little icon appearing next to the project name. Next time you want to create a project, you can use this one as a template and it'll automatically inherit its settings, which you can then further customize or change. In the same way, you can remove using a project as a template. Now, to create tags, click on the tags page in the sidebar. Simply type in a tag name and it'll be added to the list. If you want to archive it, click on the three dots and click Archive. You'll get a warning that says the tag will not be available when tracking time. To confirm the action, click Archive. Something to note is that clients, projects, tasks, and tags can be managed by different team roles, depending on how you set your preferences. Let's go to the Workspace Settings and choose the Permissions tab. You'll see that projects and clients can be created by admins, admins and project managers, or anyone. Select the option that works best for your team. The same goes for creating tasks, and for tags you can choose between admins or anyone. Customizing these lets you control who can and to which extent manage your time categorization rules. Another way you can categorize track time is through custom fields. Custom fields are time-to-time entries, and you can later filter time reports through those entries, analyze, and export only those. To create a custom field, go to the Workspace Settings, choose the Custom Fields tab, and then click Create. Now you'll see a couple of options. First, let's give the custom field a name. Add a description that'll appear when employees hover over it. Having a description helps your team know what the custom field is about. After that, choose the type of field best suited for what you want to track. A simple text field, number, link, switch button, or a selection list for one or multiple options. Click Create to save it, and it will appear at the top of the list of custom fields. To actually use it when tracking time, you can click on the custom field in the list and drag it to the visible column. Head over to the Time Tracker page and you'll see a custom field at the Time Entry field. If you want people to enter custom details for only some projects, you need to place a custom field in the invisible column. Go to the Workspace Settings and create a custom field, and then drag it to the invisible column. Now go to the project, click Settings, scroll down, and you'll see the additional fields at the bottom. Here you can mark which invisible fields will be visible for this project by turning the switch on. Now when people track time on that project, custom fields will appear. In another video, we cover reporting in detail. To learn more about reports, time tracking, and our other features, you can check out our YouTube channel, website, or help center. Thank you all for watching. Bye-bye.